My name is Holger Nils. Thanks to for the chance to speak in here. I'm working at Siemens Healthineers, and I want to present our model driven approach for the consolidation of the many distributed specifications for our scanners. Let's start with the motivation. Some words about how does computed tomography scanners are working. We have the main concept is that we have an X-ray tube and on the other side a data measurement system that rotates around the patient, and then we have an attenuation data that can be reconstructed to such impressive images. And I am especially working for the software team. We are developing the operating software, and it is running on the acquisition workplace. And our software is named Zomaris, and we are currently at version 10 or X. And our main interface is the scanner itself, which consists also of hardware and some software parts. And the third important system is the image reconstruction system, where the images are calculated. Then we have some external components like databases, printers, and some post-processing workplaces. And our software, and that's the main motivation, has to deal with different kind of scanners in one software version. And this means that the complexity will grow exponentially. Currently, we have to support four different scanners. And with the next version, we have to support 7, and then it's extended to 13, and so on. And each scanner has its own variabilities and properties, of course. And so we have an also exponentially growing maintenance effort. And we have already seen that we can flatten down this curve with model-driven approaches. And when we further invest in this approach, we might be able, or we are sure we will be able to flatten it down to a linear graph. And the final growing can be addressed with other principles and activities. Okay, so we finally want to free the resources for the feature development and not for the maintenance. What is the vision? It's about, as the title of the presentation mentions, it's about the consolidation of the specifications. So currently, the domain experts are communicating with the software experts by paperwork, and the software experts are implementing a kind of scanner model. And finally, in the system integration phase, we find the inconsistencies and all the other things. And so the feedback loop for the domain experts is very long, and this leads to expensive processes and expensive errors. And our vision is to do no longer involve the software experts in this specification process, and provide the domain experts a scanner model where they can receive the feedback directly when they make some adaptations, introduce new parameters, new behavior. And of course, we need artifacts for our long-term archive. It's for the FDA, for example, we need to archive them, but those papers are just created on demand and just stored there. That's the long-term vision, the North Star in Siemens speaking. Yeah. How to go there? Again, we are not focusing on the code generation space. Not only. It's about the entire development process. And this means that we want to get rid of the paperwork. We want to have a model that can be evaluated automatically, for example, or at least it is clear and consistent. and we want to provide our different kind of stakeholders their own language, which means physicists and product management will speak a different language. So we will provide them different editors to fill the scanner model with their aspects, with the data, finally. As you have seen, we already have invested in model-driven approaches. Also, before we find out opportunities of MPS, we used Excel sheets. We use tools like Metos for feature models. We use Enterprise Architect for state machines and other tools. But there are limitations for all the tools that are very common. They are mainly designed for developers. So UML is a nice language to define state machines for example, but there will be no physicist would learn UML. The tools don't have the possibility to present the same data in different visualizations. And I think the main limitation is they don't share their data. So there's a part of the model in different tools and different files. And there's no feedback about the entire scanner model, finally. And that's exactly where MPS comes into account. We can design editors or DSLs for each kind of stakeholders, and all can share the entire scanner model, and we can implement and provide checking rules, and so make quality assurance checks on the entire scanner model for any change a stakeholder will do. Okay. When we talk about the entire development process, then we have to also think about continuous integration. Therefore, we implemented a build chain, which means we have different repositories. So there's a repository for language development, where we implement our languages with all their aspects, as well as the generators. And this is then the base for the scanner model instance, which are persisted on a different or an own Git repository. And from this, we can create artifacts. And those artifacts could be the Word documents for the long-term archive, as well as software input, or finally code. For our Sumaro software, which is packaged and then installed on the system. So again, we have the DSL engineering workspace, and we have the DSL user workspace. And the generation of the artifacts is automated by nightly builds, where also some assessment checks are performed. Good. Some words about our language design. On the highest level, we have a global glossary, which is the place where the user or can define parameters with semantics, data types, and so on. And this these parameters can be restricted to cover the special scanner properties. And we have then the final rules catalogs, where the behavior of the concrete scanner is instantiated, is defined. So we have the platform, the concrete scanner properties, and the concrete scanner model, finally. So we address the needed flexibility by restriction and combinatorics. On the other side, we have a specification concept, which where we or the user can define metadata for the word generator. And we have a software application concept where also some metadata is defined, or the valid rules are referenced. And this is the base for our currently XML generators. Okay. Final achievements. We have a customized RCP, so it's a special version, a configured version of MPS, consisting of also our languages as plugins, and we have implemented a project navigator to enable the user to use the hierarchy approach. Also, we have a first set of checking rules, which is continuously growing, so the user can already receive direct feedback about the the quality state of the model. And of course we use, for example, constraint aspects or type system checks to guide the user and to ensure that they just define valid aspects of the model. Some impressions. Currently our users are physicists. Our physicists like tables and green, yeah. And of course they like formulas. And so we provide them their already known structure of the data and use the embedder Slython language for tables to represent the data. And you see one example of a checking rule, and of course the completion menu. And the tables are not only some combination of values, there are also some kind of mutual combination tables and so on. So we cover all the the kind of rules our physicists already know. As mentioned, we have a word generator which can be called easily. The result is, are pages with are documents with 80 pages. It includes not only the structure but also the parameters with their values, and some attributes like color highlighting for representing the changes between the last version, and some open issue annotations, for example. And there was a challenge to generate or to fill our given word template, which is defined by our process team, which has some variables for word macros with the correct data. That's why we introduced this specification concept. And we used docx for J to fill the word readable format. Okay. The second generator we have is one XML generation. So we have one part of our software receives now directly generated XML configuration files. The interface for the software already exists in the former version, but these XML files were created manually, and you see. Currently, we create XML files with up to 8 megabytes of size, and it's not very funny to create them manually. So it really makes sense to use this automation path. Good, and as mentioned, we are fully integrated into our nightly builds. We are running on a TFS server, and the assessment checks as well as the generator output is visualized by an automatically created report. And of course, there are some notifications for the users and so on. Some words about the quantity. Short look on the time. We have on the language side, we have about 20 languages, 300 meter model classes, which means concepts and editors and so on. We have 170 context-sensitive constraints, 60 test cases, 550 assertions, and the current project runtime is 2.5 years with a effort of about 3 to 4 man years. And the concrete scanner model instance consists of 16 models, 150 root nodes, and I think that's is the important number, 66,000 simple single nodes. And I want to mention, yeah, at least the first quote. One of our physicists said that with the new structure, there are no longer just a few druids which are able to understand the content of a specification. Lessons learned. We are not starting on a green field. We already have some processes to develop software, and we have to integrate into the existing processes, and we need to keep the acceptance level for this new approach very high. So we need to keep a perceivable wow effect, implement features, provide as much support as possible for the end users, don't leave them alone, and also do the development of the new approach and the new tooling in small incremental steps. Don't want too much in one step. And of course, be as non-invasive as possible. So the software defines the interface, the configuration interface, and in the special example, the XML schema, and the generator has to follow it, not vice versa. Okay, what are our next steps and therefore our challenges? We need to work in distributed teams, and this means that we have to split our scanner model data to be able to set access rights. And this means that we finally have to answer the question, how can one project import the data of another one while keeping the living data up to date? Another challenge would be for the continuous integration, it means that we also have to focus on regression testing for refactorings, for MPS version migrations. This really also requires an enhanced functionality of editor tests. So we are currently limited to cover all of our functionality in automated test cases. This is a challenge that is maybe Siemens internal. We need to further implement the tooling in our process. So when we talk about hazard code, which is defined by risk-based testing, then we have to focus on the generator quality. And when we want to replace the Word documents for the review object by the model, then we have to ensure that the visualized data is the right one. So there must not be any error in the projection. So the user or the reviewer signs for the visualized data, and that so we need to ensure that the projection is really correct. Okay, that's it from my side. Okay, the end users really use our editors, so finally the languages. So they have the possibility to instantiate tables, for example. And as the language development was in a very close cooperation with the end users, they are already trained in the concepts of the editor. But of course, we support them by the usage of the tool with the new keyboard shortcuts and so on. Currently, we have to define some trainings, for example. We provide some small videos how to use the editor, similar as the JetBrains guys do. We provide cheat sheets. And currently, our user pool is very small, and I think we have to learn how to train them in the best way. We always try to be up to date, and we want to have the scanner model on the main line always on the last version, and we have some branches for the former software versions with a special tool version to support them. So we always try to migrate the scanner model content to the very new version, at least on the main line. We do support the older versions in for our software versions, not the the MPS versions. Our software versions. And maybe the tool version used for a previous software version with Vision Siemens is based on a very last or a former MPS version. So for the last software version of the scanners, we use MPS 2017.1, I think, and currently we are on 2017.3.5, I think, for the main line. No, we are not allowed to scan ourselves. It's not about the software, it's about the German law. with the doctor, we have some market entrance phases, and if there is a doctor and says it makes sense to scan you, then we are also allowed. But it's always a decision of a doctor, because röntgen beam can harm your body. Okay, thanks.